Right now, we are in Southeast San Diego, Imperial Ave, 92114, in the bottom 69, Skyline Hills area. And what's so special about this area is Imperial is the main vein, the main artery. It goes all the way from the turf to downtown. And if you know the history about Imperials and Market Streets, that's where they used to auction shit off and buy shit, you know what I mean. But this is the perfect place for me to decide to place my billboard. Not only does it get all the right impressions, but people from every walk of life come through here, man. You see cars whizzing past right now, it's lit. It's in the morning right now, so you can only imagine how it looks in the afternoon, man. We right here, it's grimy, baby, in the turf. It don't get no better than that. Flowers out, because everybody loves flowers. Started rapping, I was a student of this. You know, my brother was in a group called Southeast One in the 90s, so I got to be inside of the studio as a young kid. And you know, what does this button do? What does that button do? I'm talking about like as a young kid in elementary. So while everybody was playing outside, I had the luxury of being able to play outside, do all the tough shit, but then go to a studio and watch my brother make records. And at the time, you know, he was doing some big records. He was a protege of Doug Rashid. Doug made a couple beats for Pac on the All Eyes on Me. They were doing some stuff with Whitney Houston. And like, for me, that was just the motivation. Like, my brother's song was getting played on the radio. So it was like a sense of pride.
Oh, yeah.
Being able to go to school and be like, that song that's on the radio, that's my brother's song. That's my brother's group. And be selling CDs and stuff. Like, so I just knew that's what I wanted to do. So when I recorded my first song, at like 16 and got to hear myself on the microphone and hear how I sounded, it was like amazing. It was mind blowing. Like, man, that's actually me, that's my voice.
You remember the name of the first song?
It's called Fiendin' for Cash.
You remember it?
Fiendin' for Cash is all I know. I got that.
Is it out somewhere? So can people find that if they look?
Actually, it is, man. I just dropped a 6-disc album called The Best of Sonny Bo, and it has like new music.
Slipped that in there though?
Yeah, I slipped that in there. You know, I slipped some of my first songs on there. Like, this four is a disc that I call Two Decades. It has music that spans from, you know, two decades from the 2000s into the 2010s. So it has 98 songs, most of it unreleased, and I have my very first song that I've ever recorded on there. I got a billboard up for my album, Flowers, and this album is like, I would consider this my lifelong masterpiece. Like, this is the album I've been striving to make my entire career. I feel like everything that I've been through prepared me for this album. It's like all the stuff that I put out before was just a precursor so that I could learn. It's almost like you go to the gym and you shoot that one shot all day, you know, to perfect it. Just so when it's game time,
you're like, that's it, I got it.
Man, pass me the ball from right here, bang, and I'm busting them buckets. But yeah, Flowers, this album, you know, I worked on it for 2 years. I had two different mastering sessions in LA for it. Like, I wanted to make sure it was perfected. And so once we got the album perfected and we dropped the album, it's like, man, well, what do we do to let the world know, or at least let the city know, first of all, that we here? Like, shit, let's put it in their faces, bro. So, you know, my bro Trap was like, man, let's get a billboard. So we went and got that billboard, and you know, after we found out, it's like, man, you know what? Nobody ever has done that here before. So it's like, it's kind of created a lot of, you know, hustle and bustle. People are paying attention to it. It's like, man, okay, they serious. Honestly, my favorite song, it would be a toss-up between, and it honestly depends on how I'm feeling that day, but it'd be a toss-up between the actual song Flowers and Cell Therapy, because it's like, those are like love songs, but from the point of view of a street cat. So it's like, it's not like no cheesy, you know, I don't want to diss nobody, it's not like no cheesy popcorn song. It's like their love song, but from the perspective of a street dude that's been through stuff. So
it's a little more relatable.
It's a little more relatable to people that live the lifestyle that I've lived. And from the deluxe edition, I would have to go with the song Off, because it's like, it's really talking about what happens to you in the streets. If you play with somebody's money, man, it, you know, it can happen. You can get off.
Yeah.
You can get off. And that's on the deluxe edition, not on the Flowers album. And the reason why I call this album Flowers is, first of all, you know, you get flowers as a sign of love. You know, Mother's Day, Valentine's Day, you know, when you're thinking about your loved ones, you bring them flowers. It's a sign of respect. You pay your condolences with flowers. You bring flowers to a funeral. So me calling this album Flowers was just me doing that. It was me giving my thanks, my gratitude, and my love. It's like we're bringing love back to the streets. Absolutely. So that's what I wanted to do with this album. I wanted to bring that back, because everybody, I feel like everybody wants to be too hardcore. Everybody wants to, you know, be too tough. It's like, but it's cool to love, man. It's cool to have love for the streets too. Even though they say the streets don't love you back, it's cool to have love for the streets. So that's why I called the album Flowers. It's like, you know, the rose, like the metaphor of the rose from out the concrete.
Yeah.
And it's produced by the Batcave from top to bottom. So shout out to the Batcave. You know, they've been one of the premier production teams in San Diego for like the last decade and a half. Like, anybody that considers himself a somebody in San Diego had to get Batcave stamped and certified at some particular point of their career.
At least that one time type of thing.
You had to, because if you didn't get a beat from the Batcave, you wasn't popping. And it's like, I'm not gonna say who and what, but I will say that some major people in the industry took that style of sound that they created and ran with it. So it's like they kind of birthed a lot of things. You know, I'm not gonna step on nobody's toes, but it's a lot of people that came and heard that and took that formula and ran with it. So it's like, for me, I feel like they formulated my sound. I feel like I sound the best on Batcave beats. So it's like, it was only right for, you know, that thing to be produced from the back by the Batcave from top to bottom. Shout out Trap Vision TV. Trap Vision is not just a vision, it is a lifestyle. But you know what? Bigger than a lifestyle, it's a way of life and it's a way of thinking. But yeah, and shout out to the Batcave, man. But other than that, man, we're gonna keep rocking. Shout out to the whole city of San Diego. Anybody that has the confidence to get out here and get on a microphone and put themselves in front of the world and say, I'm here, I salute you. If you're from my city, I salute you. You know, I'm here to tear down the borders and, you know, separation. It's like people felt like, oh, I'm from this area, I can't work with this guy from over here. It's like, I'm here to tear that stuff down, man, and say, you know, just like how my brother did when he came out, they had a group called the Southeast One. It was one Southeast, regardless of where you're from, you know. So we bring a love back to the streets with Flowers, man. We bring a love back. So if you got love for the city, San Diego, Southeast, from, you know, from El Cajon to Chula Vista, all the way up to Oceanside, man, back to Southeast, I'm rocking with you.
They symbolize my pain. So all I do is drink and smoke, drink and smoke. Think of ways to let you go. I just drink and smoke, drink and smoke. Cause I can't seem to let you go.
Main menu. To listen to your messages, press 1. Hey, new messages. First new message.
Hey, you. It's me. Just got in from a long ass day in the office and can really use your company. So if you're in town, stop by. So just make sure you got some of that platinum. Last week's proposal was not approved.
To the Batcave. Tisha, Miss Tisha, she let her smoke them Brillos. She'll stuff an eighth and two swish of sweet smoke, be the blunts of pop Skittles. Always on my line, asking where I'm at and where I've been. She got a zone of that platinum kush, chilling at the loft. It's her and her friends, and she let her enjoy both of us. Smoke out, pour up. She ain't got no kids, so she just wanna smoke and get fucked, and I usually oblige. But right now, I'm with Megan, my white chick from Napa Valley, smoking backwoods, playing PlayStation. She only smoke indica, Northern Lights, Bubba Kush, Put it in that vaporizer, have us both stuck. Can't do much, so I leave her and call Ashley. My San Francisco Bay chick. We argue about our sports teams, take J hits and get naked. I fuck her like she my mistress. She don't ever complain. All she wants is a little time to smoke weed and drink champagne. They call me on the weekends, text me during the weekdays. Forget when I don't call them back, cause I'm on the road on my campaign.
Next message.
Hey, Sonny. What's up? I just got back from the gym and I was just thinking about you. I was wondering if you can come through on your way to the studio. I just started cooking. One of the only fucking dishes I can get you to eat of mine. Garden patties on that gluten-free bread that you like with the seeds. I want you to fucking live forever. Come eat me in space, baby.
To replay, press 4.
Sonny Bo is, in my opinion, one of the most gifted and intelligent, and that's one of the best words to say, one of the most gifted and intelligent artists we have in this city. His movements and where he's moving as an artist is always progressing and always challenging the status quo of what we have. And he always disappears, takes his time, and really puts his foot into the quality of his music. And I'm fortunate enough to be able to work with him.
If people don't know, if they don't say it, they might not even know, you know. Just like, you know, he's the first one probably ever, I think, to put out a 6-disc album, you know. He's the first one in the city of San Diego to have a billboard up. You know, he's doing a lot of things that, you know, pushes the line that, you know, I don't think a lot of people give him credit for, or, you know, they might not even know that, you know.
From day one, he's been doing his own thing. He's been stayed in his own lane this whole time, and now he's like up here with the big boys where he wasn't able to be at in the beginning. And I'm glad to say that's my homeboy, you know what I mean? He's really doing a good job at what he's doing. He's doing it to the fullest. If you want to know about rap and try to do rap out here, look at the moves my boy making, and, you know, you'll get there.
My thoughts on Sonny Bo, man, he's a dope artist, but I don't want to, you know, bunch him up when I say dope artist, because Sonny Bo comes from a lineage of music, you know what I mean? His background in music runs deep. So to understand Sonny Bo, you got to understand where he come from. So, you know, get with the man, you know, from the beginning to the end, so you can understand the whole journey.
So far as me and Sonny Bo, we go back. I mean, we've been bros since the early 90s. As far as music, we started mid-2000s. Again, his brother did production. I started doing producing just because I kind of wanted to be a part. And the fact that I'm more into what's in the streets and more industry, that's kind of how I made his music and got him into basically making what's in now versus just only West Coast, just expanding his mind, expanding his rapping and getting them into doing more what's outside of our city and trying to get them that real industry sound that everybody's basically doing to be big.
Man, Sonny Bo's hot, man. Y'all better watch out for him. That Flowers is really, really something good, man. Go check that out, man. Go tell your friends about it. Go tell your mama about it. Go tell your girlfriend about it. But it's really hot, man. Flowers, deluxe edition, clean edition. Check it out.